Good morning. I'm Ginger Held, president of the Grafman Endowment Fund. On behalf of our Grafman Endowment Fund board, we want to thank you for joining us to get to know a little bit more and hear from our talented new cantor, Robbie Wittner. We know you've enjoyed his incredible voice if you have logged in to enjoy our virtual worship services. Today, we are all in for a real treat as he shares with us some of his favorite melodies. But before we get started, I do want to thank our music director extraordinaire, Paul Mosteller, who will be accompanying Robert Cantor Wittner today on the piano. And a special thanks to Caleb Young for coordinating the technology to allow us to present a first-class virtual experience. Now, I want to turn the microphone over to Robert Levin, who served as our co-chair along with Amy Kessler of the Cantorial Search Committee last year. Settle back, and I hope you enjoy today's virtual legacy luncheon.
Thank you, Ginger, and thank you, Grafman Endowment Fund. We are so excited to have Cantor Wittner with us in concert this morning. This is the second of our two-part series on getting to know Cantor Wittner. So let's review what we learned so far. Cantor Wittner was born and raised in the Washington Heights area of New York City, and that's the northernmost neighborhood in New York up by the George Washington Bridge. He grew up as a city boy in Manhattan and attended Hunter College Elementary School from preschool all the way through Hunter College High School. Now, what I know about Hunter is that it has a very rigorous set of admission criteria, so we know that Robbie is a very smart guy. Following graduation from Hunter, he went off to Hamilton College in upstate New York, which is an excellent liberal arts school. And it was there, 3 weeks prior to his graduation from Hamilton, that he met the love of his life, Alex, and they were married 4 years following graduation. Now, I'd like to point out that there is a Hamilton thread through this story. Robbie grew up in Washington Heights, and so did Lin-Manuel Miranda, who wrote and starred in Hamilton. Lin-Manuel Miranda also went to Hunter College High School, where he graduated, and he served as a substitute teacher for Robbie. Then Robbie went off to Hamilton College, which is named for Alexander Hamilton. So there it is, but I digress. Following graduation, Cantor Wittner worked in New York City for 2 years. And it was during that time that he served as a cantorial soloist at his congregation, the one he grew up in Manhattan. That was a very meaningful experience for him, and he enjoyed it very much. Now, I'd like to point out that the first person to suggest to Robbie that he should become a cantor was his mother, Mrs. Wittner. I know you're watching us this morning, and we here at Temple Emanu-El thank you for that. So it was during that time he realized that he wanted to pursue a career as a cantor, and he entered Hebrew Union College in New York City 2 years following his college graduation. We were fortunate enough to meet Robbie and Alex during that search process exactly a year ago, just prior to the pandemic. And lucky for us, Robbie accepted the position. They moved here in June and he began work in July. This morning, Robbie will be accompanied by our outstanding music director, Dr. Paul Mosteller. They've selected 7 musical selections for your enjoyment. And Robbie is going to introduce the songs, tell you a little bit about them and why he chose them. And I think by doing so, you will get a little better idea of what Robbie is all about. So, without further ado, it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you Cantor Robbie Wittner.
Welcome, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. And thank you to the Grafman Endowment Fund for having me today. It's going to be a wonderful time. Today, as Dr. Levin stated, I'm going to be sharing 7 selections of music that are significant to me in a variety of ways. The first couple became known to me when, for an early teenage birthday present, my parents gifted me a multi-CD player, which probably dates me a little bit. Along with it, they gave me a Paul Robeson CD. Now, I had been singing for a long time, mostly in choirs as a little kid, but only recently had my voice deepened significantly. And so my mom recognized that perhaps I'd like his low voice and would enjoy singing along with the CD. The first evening that I set up the system, I suppose it was that night, I lay down to go to bed and I played the CD, and I immediately fell in love with his voice and the emotional resonance he seemed to have with each of his pieces. On that CD are many classic spirituals, but also a few pieces that came from the Jewish tradition. This may have been one of the first times I recognized that there was a connection between the Black and Jewish communities and their histories of struggle. Old Man River became a favorite of mine, and I want to share it with you today. The tune was part of the Broadway hit Showboat, which premiered in 1927. Joe, the character who sings the song, was written for Paul Robeson specifically, but he wasn't able to participate in the Broadway premiere because he was busy. He did partake, though, in the West End production of the show a year later and starred in the film version in 1936. Due to his musical talents, I've been a longtime fan of Robeson, but my love and respect for him became even greater when I later realized that he was such a major Black rights activist in this country. In many ways, he was ahead of his time, and unfortunately, he was blacklisted in the McCarthy era. I'll speak a bit about the next piece after this one, but for now, enjoy Old Man River.
An old man called a Mississippi. That's the old man that I'd like to be. What does he care if the world's got troubles? What does he care if the land ain't free? Old Man River, Dad, Old Man River. He must know something, but don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling, he keeps on rolling along. He don't plant taters, he don't plant cotton. And them that plants some is soon forgotten. But Old Man River, he just keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain, body all aching and racked with pain. Toting that barge, lift that bale, you get a little drunk and you land in jail. Well, I get weary and sick of trying. I'm tired of living and scared of dying. But Old Man River, he just keeps rolling along.
This next piece I also discovered on that same Robeson CD, but it has a totally different tone and style to this last piece. In fact, it wasn't until about 15 years after originally hearing it that in cantorial school I discovered where this piece came from. This song's text was written by an 18th century rabbi from Poland named Levi Yitzchak of Berdichev. He was a Hasidic master and was generally regarded as one of the superstar rabbis of his era. He wrote this song called Adin Toyga mit Gott in Yiddish, pleading with God, and asking why the Jews have been treated so terribly over the years. Centuries later, the composer Yoel Engel, who was part of the St. Petersburg Society of Composers and who was a major influence in Jewish art song in the late 19th century and early 20th century, he composed a version of this piece. Paul Robeson, who did sing plenty of songs in Yiddish, actually sang an anglicized version of this piece, and that is what I will share with you today.
A good day to the Lord God Almighty. I, Levi Isaac, son of Sarah from Berdichev, here am I before thee with a grave and earnest plea from thy people Israel. What hast thou done to us, thy people Israel? Why hast thou so oppressed us, thy people Israel? Wherever sorrows follow the sons of the oppressed, whoever suffers all of the sons of the oppressed, whatever be tried, there is spite against the sons of the oppressed of God on high. On this earth how many nations? The Persians, the Romans, the Babylonians, the Germans, what boast they? Our ruler is above all rulers. The Germans, what boast they? Our kingdom is above all kingdoms. But I, Levi Isaac, son of Sarah, from Berdichev do declare, Yiskandal, the Yiskandash, Shemei Ramba. And I, Levi Isaac, son of Sarah, from Berdichev declare, from my place I will not move, for I will not move from this place, and an end let there be to all this sorrow and suffering. Yiskandal, ve'yiskandash, Shemei Rabo.
Until college, all of the singing I did was either choral or it was me just singing at family events for those attending. I hadn't had any proper voice lessons until I was offered a scholarship by the choir director at Hamilton College. I was lucky enough to study with the great Heldon tenor John Frederick West, and two of the first pieces that I ever sang with him under his tutelage were a couple of Broadway classic tunes from South Pacific, This Nearly Was Mine and Some Enchanted Evening. The show premiered in 1949, written by Rodgers and Hammerstein, Hammerstein being the composer of Showboat as well, by the way. These two pieces don't have the same kind of story behind them that the first two did for me, but they're absolutely gorgeous pieces of music, and I can't wait to share them with you. I am quite a romantic at heart, and these fit the bill of something I'd want to share. So, Maestro, take it away.
To be living for, one love to be living for, this nearly was mine, one girl for my dreams, one partner in paradise. This promise of paradise, this nearly was mine. close to my heart she came, only to fly away, only to fly as day flies from moonlight. Now I'm alone, still dreaming of paradise, still saying that paradise once nearly was mine. So clear and deep are my fancies of things I wish were true. I'll keep remembering evenings I wish I'd spent with you. I'll keep remembering kisses from lips I'll never own, and all the lovely adventures that we have never known. Now I'm alone, still dreaming of paradise, still saying that paradise once nearly was mine. Enchanted evening, you may see a stranger, you may see a stranger across a crowded room, and somehow you know even then, that somewhere you'll see her again and again. Some enchanted evening, someone may be laughing, you may hear her laughing across a crowded room, and night after night, as strange as it seems, the sound of her laughter will sing in your dreams. Who can explain it? Who can tell you why? Fools give you reasons, wise men never try. Some enchanted evening, when you find your true love, when you feel her call you across a crowded room, then fly to her side and make her your own. Or all through your life you may dream all alone. Once you have found her, never let her go. Once you have found her, never let her go.
Growing up in New York City, my parents took me to a lot of Yankees games, starting at a young age. I became a huge fan at around 5 or 6 years old, and baseball became the new thing I couldn't stop talking about, taking over from my previous obsession of Power Rangers. Over the years, I attended many Yankees games, and they all ended with the theme from New York, New York, sung by none other than Frank Sinatra. It became something I looked forward to hearing to, and part of the atmosphere of the game. When I was preparing for this event, I started to wonder to myself, does New York, New York play after every game at Yankee Stadium, or just after wins? As it turns out, as a child, through the about 30-odd games that I ever attended, the Yankees never lost any of those games, which was truly incredible. And so I wasn't sure whether the song played after losses, though to be clear, I have attended a couple of losses now. And I began to look into the matter. It turns out that 30-plus years ago, when the Yankees won, they played the Sinatra version, and when they lost, they played the original Liza Minnelli version. Minnelli, unsurprisingly, was not happy with this situation, and the Yankees decided that they would just play the Sinatra version after every game. New York will always be a special part of me, and a new part of me is now Alabama. I originally planned to sing Sweet Home Alabama to pair with New York, New York, but our own Dr. Levin here suggested an alternative, which is Stars Fell on Alabama. I have to admit that I had actually never heard Stars Fell on Alabama before this suggestion, and I can't thank him enough for suggesting it to me. It's so tender and lovely and serves as a perfect foil to New York, New York. So sit back and enjoy the sounds of these two great parts of our nation. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York, New York. I wanna wake up in a city that never sleeps and find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York. New York, New York. I wanna wake up in a city that doesn't sleep and find I'm a number one, top of the list, cream of the crop at the top of the heap. These little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York, New York.
Thank you.
tremor. We kissed in a field of white, and stars fell on Alabama last night. I can't forget the glamour. Your eyes held a tender light, and stars fell on Alabama last night. I never planned in my imagination a situation so heavenly, a fairyland where no one else could enter, and in the center, just you and me, dear. My heart be like a hammer, my arms wound around you tight, and stars fell on Alabama last night. And stars fell on Alabama last night.
The summer before sixth grade, I was selected to be what was called a student ambassador for a program called People to People. My trip took me and a group of other teenagers to Australia for 3 weeks, away from our parents. It was a wonderful trip, and when I came back, I was so jet-lagged, I ended up sleeping for the majority of 3 days. Unfortunately, right in the middle of those 3 days, my mother and I were scheduled to see the Broadway show Man of La Mancha with Brian Stokes Mitchell. And I didn't know the musical at the time, but my mom assured me that I would enjoy it. And we went, and of course I did love it, or I probably wouldn't be telling you the story right now. It became one of my favorite musicals, and a song that I love performing is The Impossible Dream from this show. Became a favorite of mine, and so I invite you to dream on with me while hearing this song.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable stars. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable stars. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, was to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this. Not one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable stars.
Thank you, Robbie. Thank you, Paul. What a wonderful concert. What a wonderful experience. I know I speak for all of us when I say we look forward to the time where you too can join us in this beautiful chapel, in our magnificent sanctuary, and listen to Cantor Wittner in person, because it is just breathtaking. Just a wonderful experience. And even though this is the end of getting to know Cantor Wittner of our two-part series, this should not be the end of concerts that you will be doing for us. So we all look forward to that in the future. And by the way, you did not know Stars Fell in Alabama 1 week ago. And you sang that every bit as well as you did New York, New York. So there's a lot of meaning there somewhere, Robbie. So just think about that. Now, thank you so much. Thank you, Jan Blitz, the director of our endowment fund, for asking me to be part of this. I thank you. This was a wonderful experience. I'm going to turn the program back over to Ginger Held at this time.
Thanks, Robert. I don't know about y'all, but I couldn't sit still in my chair. I mean, this was incredible. Thanks again, Robert and Paul, and especially Cantor Wittner. We are so fortunate to have Robbie join our clergy team this year. Your voice certainly enhances our spiritual experience. The Grafman Endowment Fund takes great pride in putting on exceptional programs like this one and providing special enhancements that we enjoy here at Temple Emanu-El. As many of you might know, Cantor Wittner enjoys holding the Engel Cantorial Chair. This means that his position is partly funded and endowed by one of our many funds within our Grafman Endowment Fund. Our congregation is so blessed to have such financial stability and all the extras, thanks to our incredible Grafman Endowment Fund and its many donors. In normal times, we would conclude our program by joining together for lunch in Abrams Hall. Although we are not together, I trust that you will soon be enjoying your lunch in the comfort of your home or your office. So, Cantor Wittner, would you please come and lead us in the Hamotzi?
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Hamotzi Lechem Min Haaretz B'tei Avon.
Thank you for joining us, everybody.